MiG-15, the younger sibling of that MiG-15 I was talking about earlier from the Korean conflict, boasts that more powerful jet with the aftermath.
Since 1919. It is the first Marine Aviation Squadron. It's been around for over 100 years now, proudly serving in the Marine Corps with multiple types of aircraft. It makes sense that we do this air show. Get your cameras ready, folks. Borky's coming around now for the photo pass. He's gonna give you a nice plan form of the aircraft, slowing it down a little bit. So get those phones out, get those cameras out, and get a picture of this beautiful piece of living history that continues to serve today.
Thank you.
can perform a vertical takeoff from a prepared surface or a rolling vertical takeoff from almost any surface. This allows the pilot great flexibility in choosing among the takeoff areas available. As he's circling around now, he's going to be configuring for landing. You'll see some black smoke coming out. Nothing to worry about, that's just him activating the water. The Harrier carries about 500 pounds of demineralized water to increase thrust by about 1,000 pounds. And just to remind you, when he comes in, it's going to get pretty loud, so put your protection on and watch the beauty of this. This is one of the last true stick and rudder jet aircraft in the U.S. fleet at the moment. There is no computer helping him. He is manually controlling those nozzles, manually controlling the aircraft with hydraulics and the reaction control system, which shoots bleed air from the wingtips, the nose, and the tail to maintain control of the aircraft and slow down.
Thank you.
We'll see you tomorrow.
Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, Major Mike Fucci and the entire AV-8B Harrier 2 Plus demo team. Let's give them a big round of applause.
Thanks, partner.
See ya. Tom Larkin's out there. He's going to be signing some autographs along the crowd here in just a second. Responsible for providing expeditionary detachments aboard naval vessels and as security forces for naval shore installations and U.S. diplomatic missions in foreign countries. The Marine Corps was founded on November 10, 1775, by order of the Continental Congress. On that day, two battalions of Marines were raised for service as landing forces within the naval fleet. Since then, Marines have served in every major U.S. naval action and have executed more than 300 landings on foreign.